Paramahansa Nityananda, a compelling spiritual force of our millennium, founder of an international socio-spiritual movement, pioneer of a modern Vedic Renaissance. Born in the sacred town of Tiruvannamalai, a yogi by birth, fearless spiritual explorer, beacons of divine power, Paramahamsa Nityananda is today an inspiration for millions on the path. Adept in ancient mystical yogic sciences, researcher of the science of spirituality, guru for enlightenment. Every year, Paramahamsa Nityananda shares with over 1 crore people worldwide the treasures of his wisdom, the joy of his laughter, and the incomparable power of his initiation. Now, Paramahamsa Nityananda reveals the deeper secrets of life, science of life. Join us every day for an unforgettable spiritual experience.
December 21st, 2012. The most searched word in the internet today. The subject for countless articles. The end of time in the Mayan calendar, reiterated by the I Ching. A yet to find in the predictions of Nostradamus. A dreadful climax in the forecast of science. Yet, a few say, it is a stunning leap in human consciousness. The world waits with bated breath for a definitive direction. Is it an end or a beginning for humanity? A rare living incarnation, spiritual genius, guiding light for millions, most watched guru on YouTube.com, Paramahamsa Nityananda, unleashes the truths of 2012, as is.
I welcome you all with my love and respects. One of the most talked subject in the whole world, in all medias, not just in Hollywood or Bollywood or Gollywood or TV, even in the internet. One of the most talked about mysterious subject. I was surprised to see the statistics. More people come to internet for 2012 than pornography. Understand? Porno is the largest internet-based industry. But more people come to internet now in search of 2012 than porno. I can go on giving you many statistics. The importance of 2012. Almost all the ancient civilizations, except the Vedic civilization, all the ancient civilizations' calendars are ending by 2012. Mayan, I Ching, so many prophecies. Even the modern day prophecy methods, prediction methods, Webmart, even those things, Webmart is the system which studies all the softwares, languages and words and collective unconsciousness of the world and predicted 9/11 attack, Katrina. Many accurate predictions have been done by the Webmart. Even the Webmart program predicts the end in 2012. So much is spoken continuously about 2012 by so many ancient civilizations and so many religious groups, spiritual groups, religious leaders, spiritual masters. So everybody wants my prediction about the 2012. Understand, I am not interested in prediction. I'll just tell you exactly what is going to happen. You understand the truth as it is. Just few months before, I had a very strange, strong experience. I wanted to share with you all. From that, I can tell you exactly. What is going to happen? One day morning, I was trying to jog, run, do some exercise in treadmill. Usually when I am in the ashram, I try to walk early morning. If I am not able to come out due to some program, if too much of crowd in the ashram, I try to do little running in the treadmill. Because I cannot do any yoga. If I do yoga, body falls into samadhi. So I can only do something which I can hold on to some structure. So I was doing little running. Usually when I move my body in particular postures, if the body sets in particular postures, or if the breathing gets activated and falls in particular rhythm, body falls into samadhi. Falls into samadhi means just goes out of my control. Kind of I'll feel being inside a big balloon. But I was shocked and surprised. My body is constantly falling into samadhi and I was trying to jog, but things are not out of my control. Please understand, I was jogging, means the breathing naturally gets altered and body is falling into samadhi continuously. I counted, within 60 seconds, 42 times body was kicked into samadhi. Almost like every alternative second. But the funny thing is, it is not getting imbalanced. I was completely balanced. I got so much of confidence. I thought, oh God, body is really settled very well. The physical body is nicely matched, settled with the samadhi state of consciousness. Then I tried little risky things like a yogasana, bending the body and doing some trigonasana. Trigonasana puts your whole kundalini in one line, the kundalini energy in one line. Trigonasana and few Surya Namaskar. I was shocked. Body gets kicked into samadhi, but I am not imbalanced. First time, this kind of experience, because whenever my body falls into samadhi, I'll get imbalanced. But body is falling into samadhi, but I'm not getting imbalanced. I started contemplating, how come? Why? When I meditated, one important truth was revealed inside me. I realized, see, the center of the earth, globe center, which is the center of the whole rotation, centrifugal force. See, the earth is continuously rotating, constantly. Because of its centrifugal force only, the gravitation is created. And the earth is the center of the earth is constantly attracting everything towards it. I realized the center of the earth is slowly losing its power to pull the things towards its center. Means the gravitation is reducing, the power of gravity is reducing. Please understand. By nature, your weight is getting reduced maybe 0.001 milligrams. Physically, you will not experience it. Now, physically it may not be big for you, but one important thing you need to understand, it will have a huge psychological effect, because even your thoughts have mass. If the gravitation power, in a subtle way, if it starts reducing, your body can move with less thoughts, more actions. Please understand. Your body can experience a space of less thought, more actions. For example, now, for you to get up from here, go to kitchen, have dinner and come back. For this action, if you need 100 thoughts, by next year, you may need only 70 thoughts. You without doing any spiritual practice. Please understand. Because the center of the earth is reducing its power over things to pull everything towards its center. The gravity power is getting reduced. I was really shocked. Oh God, what is going to happen? What is its effect on human beings? That is what I started contemplating. It is continuously reducing. The center of gravity, the center, which is constantly attracting everything towards itself, is losing its power over everything. I can say maybe consciously itself is that center is deciding to relax a little bit, reduce the gravitation force. So by 2012, atleast 6 milligram, all objects will physically weigh less. Understand? Physically will weigh less. And I say 6 milligram, it's like a if something is 1 ton now, by 2012, 6 milligram will be less. Physically measurable weight. But 6 milligram may not be a big thing in the physical plane. It is something extraordinary in the inner space. See, even the thoughts have mass. When the pull is getting reduced, your body can act with less thoughts. It is going to have a huge effect on human beings. I wanted all of you to know this important truth. By 2012, even if you don't do anything, you are going to weigh less physically. Second, less number of thoughts for same action. Now this is going to have two effects, two different effects on people. If you are habituated to be with less number of thoughts, if you are in tune with that feeling less number of thoughts, you will call that as a peace and bliss. If you are not habituated for less number of thought lifestyle, you are going to name that as depression. Understand? People who are not conscious enough, intelligent enough, aware enough to be comfortable with less thoughts, more action, is going to brand, label that experience unconsciously as depression. If you have prepared your body and mind for less number of thoughts, you are going to experience that as enlightenment. Choice is in your hands. Understand? I have already described the effect, what is going to happen. Whether the 2012 is doomsday or enlightenment day, your choice. This is what is going to be effect. How you are going to prepare yourself is going to decide whether it is a doomsday or enlightenment day. Understand? All civilizations which are thinking based, constantly driving you to think and feels thought is productivity, is going to just disappear into depression. You need to understand it very clearly. All the civilizations and societies which goes on emphasizing on thinking, where thinking is celebrated, where thinking is equated to productivity, where thinking is equated to being alive, even for entertainment, thinking is important. Thinking becomes an entertainment. It is almost like in Tamil we have a proverb, taking a fire stick and scratching your head because it is itching. Most of our entertainments are picking up a firewood, burning firewood and scratching your head because it is itching. Even for entertainment, people think more. So all thinking-based civilization is going to hit one of the worst depression. Means it is going to be doomsday for them. All civilizations which prepares human beings to be comfortable with non-thinking zone, that being zone, the unclutched zone, for them, it is going to be the greatest celebration and liberation. Suddenly, your nervous system is going to be having less load. If you think the load on the nervous system is your productivity, the goal of life, value of life, utility of life, it is going to be depression, doomsday, hell. If you think less load on the nervous system is ecstasy and joy, if you are prepared psychologically and consciously to be with less load on the nervous system, it is going to be celebration and liberation. Understand? We may think why the great civilizations like Mayans, I Ching from China, there is a book called Book of Change, I Ching, why all of them predict huge destruction. Understand? Usually prophecies are created not to tell what is going to happen, to prepare how you need to be prepared for the happening. It is not that they are saying exactly there is going to be huge destruction as shown in the 2012 movie. No. Don't think there is going to be a huge tsunami and the ships are going to be on the Washington. As shown. And the LAX airport is going to give way. As shown in the movie. No. It is not going to be physical destruction. But it is going to be a huge change. It is in our hands whether to use that as a jumping pad and enter into enlightenment, or fall into depression and suffer. There is going to be a huge change in the consciousness. That is why no Eastern tradition has predicted, no Vedic prophecies has predicted end of the world by 2012. No. It is only going to be end of the low consciousness. The possibility for a huge, the enlightened civilization is opening up by 2012. And I tell you, people who learn the science of unclutching and prepare themselves will just use this as a jumping pad and become enlightened. We are going to have millions of enlightened beings without much effort. Without much effort. Millions of enlightened people. All you need is just sit 20-30 minutes a day and be comfortable with the space of unclutching. That's all. When the number of thoughts reduces automatically, don't be depressed saying that somebody has stolen your property. You reduce your luggage. Don't have that fear, oh, somebody is taking away your property. Don't have that insecurity. Less thought means less productive, less being alive. No. Be comfortable with that less thought, more action space. That's all you need. This is the greatest preparation, best preparation for 2012. I am not only telling you what is exactly going to happen, I am giving you the choice, all possibilities, so you can choose what you want. All thinking-based civilizations and societies are going to face terrible depression because they do not know what to do when automatically the number of thoughts is reducing on their nervous system. They think they are becoming inefficient and depressed. They are going to use all kinds of medicines and alcohol and addictive drugs and everything, and going to get into the self-destruction, destroying their body and mind. But the civilizations, societies which are comfortable with that non-thinking zone is going to take a quantum leap and get into the space of enlightenment. See, there are three zones. One, less thought, less actions. It's called tamas, depression. More thought, more actions. That's called rajas, activeness, restlessness. there is a third space, less thought, more actions, sattva. All of us know this first two space, less thought, less action, lazy, feeling dull, we can mood. And we know more thought, more actions, Monday mood. Unfortunately, we do not know a space called less thought, more actions, sattva. Now, by nature, you are going to fall into the space of less thought. What are you going to do? How are you going to handle it? Are you going to end up with less thought, less action, or less thought, more action? It's a road, two different roads. Are you going to pick up tamas, inertia, depression, less thought, less action, or less thought, more action? The choice is in your hands. One more thing, please understand. One of the rarest happening of nature reducing its force and reducing the number of thoughts in your inner space, rarest happening after this 2012, again this visible reduction may happen only after 2000 years. So rare possibility to get enlightened. You are on the planet in right time with the right person. In right time with right philosophy, right person. It's a huge possibility. Don't miss it. Don't miss it. I know some people who missed last time when it happened. When Krishna was in the body, it happened once. And all these grahas, planets, had the same alignment when Krishna was in the body. If you study astronomically, you will find it. Astrology and astronomy, if you study, you will find it. The reason for this energy to happen on the planet Earth, the aligning of certain planets, happened when Krishna was in the body once. But people who missed, waited for 5000 years and landed again on the planet Earth. Many have landed again. Don't miss this time. Because it is such a natural lift. It's almost like all you need to do is just open the flag in your boat and go with the air, go with the trend. Automatically your number of thoughts will get reduced day by day. Don't associate depression with less number of thoughts. Unfortunately, from the young age, you are constantly taught by the thinking-based civilizations that less number of thought means depression. You feel, I am missing something. I need to put something into my system to excite me, whether it is a drug or food or caffeine or coffee or thoughts to excite. No, relax. You don't need anything to excite you. Feel comfortable with that less thought space. That will get translated itself into more action space. Less thought, more action. Sattva. The peace. Restful awareness. So much of prediction about this 2012, all over the internet. This is going to happen, that is going to happen, that is going to happen. All thinking-based civilizations are predicting doomsday. All being-based civilizations are predicting enlightenment. Actually, both are true. If you are a thought-based person, unable to catch up with the reality of less thoughts, it is going to be doomsday. Heavy depression. And there is going to be huge mass suicide. And all the countries and societies ruled by the depressed people are going to have war with others, blaming others responsible for their suffering. There is going to be huge destruction. Understand, you have the responsibility to become conscious, enlightened, and choose enlightened beings as the head of your civilization and society, country. So, we need urgently few million enlightened beings in all major fields of bureaucracy, politics, in all major fields to protect planet Earth. Understand the urgency. Anyhow, the enlightened beings are not going to be affected, disturbed. But I wanted to warn the human civilization. You need immediately at least few million enlightened beings. People who are very comfortable with the less thought zone, unclutched space. People who don't fall into depression. See, when there is less thought, when you fall into depression, even the small mistakes which others do looks too much. Too much. And you just go for war. War is nothing but a friction, explosion of friction. You don't need a big reason for it. The friction goes on getting built. Just one reason, he stared at me, is enough. He'll start slapping. And one slap is enough for the other person to repeat. You respond. Nothing else is required. You don't need a big reason to go for a war. If you want to save yourself, just learn the science of unclutching. Be comfortable with less thought space. You will not be harmed by 2012. If you want to use this great opportunity of 2012, just get enlightened. And if you want to save the planet Earth, see that all the people who are decision makers for your life, head of your country, head of your civilization, head of your society, your religious leader, your political leader, people who think for you, people who decide for you, political decision, social decision, religious decisions, inspire all of them to get enlightened. Inspire all of them to be in tune, be comfortable with the less thought space, so that they make right decisions for you. Understand? Now you have a huge social responsibility. Important part which Vedic tradition people were avoiding continuously. Especially in the Hindu tradition, people were always thinking, if you get enlightened, that's enough. Now that is not going to be enough. That is not going to be enough. What are you going to do? Sitting in just empty island, all by yourself, having few trees which will give fruit for your food. Not only you escaping, save few people so that you can celebrate your life with them. Save planet Earth. We have put our ancestors, our elders, our predecessors put too much energy to create this huge infrastructure. Let it not be destroyed by foolish, unconscious politicians and unconscious religious theories, theologies, which goes on creating hatred amongst each other and becoming base for terrorism in the planet Earth. Two things. One, you falling in tune with the less thought space means learning the science of unclutching and using this 2012 less thought, more action zone for enlightenment. Use this as a jumping pad to get enlightened. This is the first thing. Second thing, now itself go all out, work hard, put at least 4-5 hours to save planet Earth by spreading the science of unclutching. That is why I am saying all the important science and the technology which is needed to save planet Earth and raise its consciousness, I am making it completely freely available in the social media and mass media and internet. I am not asking you to popularize my name as author, no. I am requesting you take this science and spread it all over the world like a wildfire. The science of enlightenment, feeling comfortable with less scars through unclutching. So if you spread this science, especially the decision makers, people who decide for you, your political leaders, your social leaders, your religious leaders, give them all this science, give them all this great truth of what planet Earth is going through. She is really delivering. She is just delivering new consciousness. See, during the Krishna's happening, the same thing happened. People are not able to evolve themselves to the level of less thought, more actions. Krishna saw these guys are going to be dangerous. So he just created the war under the controlled conditions and finished all of them off. Understand? If Krishna wouldn't have created that Mahabharata war, there would have been huge uncontrolled chaos. So Krishna managed. The whole chaos was in his controlled condition. It's like still now, the Western countries, during the fire season, they do something like a controlled fire and finish off so that the fire does not become wildfire. It does not go out of control, out of hand. So particular areas, they will burn it and make a fire line. It's called controlled fire. Same way, Krishna created an ambience where the chaos is under the controlled conditions and created and finished everything. Understand? Now, in 2012, we are entering the same space. I feel from now to 2012, if we create at least 2 million enlightened beings, people who are comfortable with less thought, more action, by 2012 to 2015, we will have at least 20 million enlightened beings on the planet Earth. We will have enlightened civilization. Please understand, I am not playing with your fear or greed. I am not giving you the dream of utopia. No. I am not giving you the dream of paradise. No. I am not threatening you I am not frightening you with some fear prediction. No, I am just straight away stating the simple fact, knowing well I am going to be available in this body alive 2012 and 2015 and all, and this video record will be used by people to question me. Knowing this, I am making all these statements. Very responsibly I am talking. Understand? Planet Earth is entering into a space where automatically we are all getting into the zone of less thoughts. All you need is prepare your body and mind. If you prepare your mind with unclutching science, you will feel comfortable with that less thoughts and you will not fall into depression. You will become enlightened. If you prepare your body also with Hatha Yoga, not only you will become enlightened, you will start expressing extraordinary powers like levitation. I tell you, the levitation is going to be more easy by 2012. Let me announce now itself, by 2012 end, I will make 10,000 people levitate in one space and create a huge positive consciousness. That is going to be a big push for the human consciousness to enter into the divine consciousness. That will be the opening of Satya Yuga, the age of enlightenment. See, actually what happens when you levitate, you know, it's like a master's body is a light, radiating light. All your body and mind, when it just sits unclutched way, it's like a 10,000 mirrors reflecting the master's consciousness. Then what happens? 10,000 fold the same light gets zoomed. 10,000 laser beams get centered. Come on, then imagine. It is equivalent to 10,000 enlightened beings sitting in Samadhi, Shambhala in planet Earth. Shambhala in planet Earth. When you levitate, exactly that is what happens. Your body and mind is like a mirror. It just gets focused, properly placed towards Master's consciousness. So his bio-memory is transmitted into you. Your body becomes light and just flows in the ether, flows with the nature. So if 10,000 people, 10,000 body and minds focuses itself into the master's consciousness, you understand, you see, in front of one light, if you keep five mirror, the light is going to be five times more, fivefold. It has five mirrors, it is reflecting, and the whole area is lit intensely. Same way, in front of one incarnation's consciousness, if 10,000 mirrors are kept, so 10,000 fold that super consciousness is going to reflect, an intense energy field will be created. Superconscious energy field. So I am planning, by the divine grace, I know it will be fulfilled successfully with all auspiciousness, to have 10,000 enlightened body and mind levitating in enlightened consciousness, radiating enlightenment, to push the whole consciousness of planet Earth to the next level, to the cosmic consciousness, to the next level of the divine consciousness, between 12-12-12 to January 1st, 2013. In the 21 days, we will have an intense inner awakening program where 10,000 people will be just focused on the Master's consciousness, reflecting it and radiating, experiencing beautiful levitation into the cosmic consciousness, so that we push the whole consciousness into the next level. So understand, this will completely heal all the negativity created by political differences and ideological differences. This is my humble gift to the planet Earth and human consciousness. I invite all of you to be part of this great, joyful, successful journey of pushing human consciousness into the next level, transforming the human consciousness into divine consciousness by 2012. Let us prepare ourselves and prepare the planet Earth to enter into that space. Between 2012 and 15 only, I am seeing the great positive explosion in consciousness. Let us get ready, liberate and celebrate. I wanted this to be the theme for the 2012, liberate and celebrate. I invite all of you for this great journey of transforming our individual consciousness and the global consciousness, entering into the great Satya Yuga 2012. Let's experience the enlightenment which 2012 is waiting to share with us, which 2012 is offering to us. So let us march towards 2012. Thank you.
Welcome to Inner Awakening, the most powerful personal transformation retreat you could ever experience. In just 21 days, thousands are already experiencing the shortest route to constantly high energy levels, visible anti-aging, healing of chronic diseases, fulfilling relationships, and higher states of consciousness. What is the secret behind this transformation?
Kundalini means the inner potential energy. Once it is awakened, opens the different doors for the conscious experience in you. I can say which is a master key for all extraordinary spiritual experience.
This extraordinary program is conducted personally by Paramahamsa Nityananda in the vibrant atmosphere of Nityananda Dhyanapitam Ashram. Open yourself to the benefits of Nitya Yoga and practical meditation. Experience physical and mental healing. Discover simple ways to handle life with success. Above all, enjoy individual darshan and blessings from Paramahamsa Nityananda every day. Take 21 days for yourself and carry home the transformation of a lifetime.